Hey there guys, welcome to a Gaming Night's Kickstarter preview game. So this is Elemen'z, and it's designed by, it says Jason McLean Jones. I'm not 100% sure that's right. This is obviously a prototype. This is by a company called Bad Cat Games. That is right. Right, so Elemen'z is, each person is playing a Master Shaman. So this was looks what the Master Shamans look like. And every 7 years, we do battle with the other Master Shamans, who I'll introduce in a second. And we have to fight for the control of Planet Z for the following 7 years. It's based on elements, so as you can see, Roxin is a fire elemental. And this is going to be played by John Batchelor.
Hello.
We have Mike.
I am playing Ik Zakrathvek. And you are? They call him Squirtle. He's water.
Water. Tony?
Kreeks.
And you are?
Earth.
Earth. And Molo?
Xyline. And I seem to be a birdie looking thing. So air.
Okay, so the way this game works is each person is going to have a little player board. And 7 of their element dice. Now the element dice will have 2 of your element on, and then 1 of everything else, including a Z. Now Z's are wild, and I'll get more on them in a second. What you're going to do on your turn? Everyone will start the game with 2 dice in their shields. Right. So all these guys are going to have 2 dice starting the shields. And the relevance behind that is obviously the first player will get a heavy bonus if they can attack everyone without shields. So everyone starts with shields. And then, on your turn, when it's your turn, you scoop up all your dice. And just like you think of King of Tokyo and those type of games, you roll the dice, and then you can choose ones you want to keep. So for example, I might keep that fire, I might keep that fire. I need a couple of mountains if I want to do that. I haven't rolled any mountains. Z's can be used as wild. And then of course, these others are other elements, which still can be used. So for example, Lava Surge needs water, Pyroblast needs air. But, because I'm fire, if I roll all waters, so if somehow all my dice come up in the beginning with waters, then I am done. That'll end my turn. Or, if I roll 3 Z's, that'll also end my turn, as my power is overloaded, and I no longer can control the magic. But, 1 Z is not too bad. I can actually allocate that like that, for example. And let's say that was a mountain. I could allocate that. So that's not a problem. I would have then done this combo, which I could choose someone to lose 2 dice. We'll go back to that in a second. Z's on their own, you can't add 2 Z's, for example, like that, because Z's need to be anchored next to something. So for example, that one's a mountain, so I could do that, for example. But once you've done your 3 rerolls, you then stuck with the dice you have. So let's say I roll these. Oh great, I've rolled 4 Z's.
Good example.
I've got another reroll, so I'm gonna reroll those. Okay, that's better. So, these are the dice I have to allocate. Now, this is my player board. These are the things where I allocate. Anything with a little diamond on means I can keep it there for the remainder of the round and do stuff in other people's turns. So, this one allows me to reroll 1 dice of a target opponent. I can add things to shields. If I only add 1, I only have 1 shield. If I add 2, I have 2 shields. I can do a couple of strikes. I can do other various things. Things that says strike is when you attack someone and they block with their shields. Things that says lose, so for example, if I do firestorm, and I say I do it on Michael, which is one of our targets.
Yep, Jason always does.
He would lose 2 dice. And what that means is he takes 2 dice from his available pool and he adds them into the middle. As soon as he's run out of a dice, he's eliminated.
So dice are your life, basically.
Exactly that, yeah.
The life of a gamer. Dice.
Yeah. And obviously the lower person standing with remaining dice is the winner. There's ways you can get back dice. If you roll all your same symbols, so if I roll all fires, I can take 1 dice back from the pool. And there's a couple little things. Now, I believe this is going to be a Kickstarter exclusive item. This is your totems. So each person will get a totem. Obviously, remember, this is prototypes. They get filled with 1 token each. And they do a couple of things. One, you can allocate dice to those areas as part of your combo action to gain that dice. So this one allows me an extra reroll. Or, if someone attacks you and makes you lose or strikes you for dice, you could spend 2 tokens. I could get rid of those 2 tokens and save, like, in other words, I won't lose that dice. But, if I roll all Z's, all the tokens will be cleared off. Or, if I Let's say this turn I did the two dice thing, and the next turn someone attacks me and I do it again. Now I've got no tokens in here. The totem will dissipate, and you will lose that totem for the rest of the game. But this is not a long game. This is like a 15-minute game, so don't think of that as too big a deal. So that's pretty much it. Each person goes round and round until there's only one shaman left, and that person is declared the winner. You can obviously add more tokens here, by the way. For example, if I put a fire there, I go into the bag and take out another token and put it back on the dice. There we go. So each person has unique abilities. The firepower, as you can see there, those two, I don't know if you can actually see it, they are already indented. So, for example, the searing heat only needs a water, an air rather. That's always in there. Your one is...
Roll one water to recover extra dice.
Yeah, so when you're recovering dice from the middle of the pool, if it's like your first or second roll, you can still roll the dice. But you have a special power. When it comes to you, like you've rolled, let's say you've rolled all water, you take one back, you get to roll that one again. If you roll water again, you get another one back.
Aha.
And Tony...
One extra free dice added to dice in shield.
Yeah, so for example, that second mountain you got there, you don't have to put that there. Because it's already...
It's free.
Yeah, it's free. So you only need one mountain to make both shields. But you can't... Like, that's... If you don't put a dice there, you don't have any shields. And yours is...
A free reroll of one dice a turn.
That's pretty good as well. So you can have one extra reroll, but only one dice. Okay, so that's the rules. We're going to play through a couple of turns. We'll show you a live playthrough as well. And then we'll come back and tell you where you can go to check out this game. Alright, so this is the gameplay turn. The guys have all had a round each quickly just to get familiar with the rules and get the game flowing. So John was the first player and he's going to now take his turn. So first thing he does is scoop up all his dice, including his shield, and then he has a roll.
John's already best to do this.
John's already lost one dice as someone attacked him. Tony's looking a bit vulnerable because he rolled three Z's at the end of his... Well, actually he rolled two and then Molo made him re-roll one to get the three Z's. So that's what the dice have lost so far.
I'm going to keep that. And I'm going to keep that so far. Re-roll these ones. So let's re-roll.
Yep. And you got one roll left.
I'll have that. And then last one.
Okay. Oh! Two or two Z's. So Z's are obviously wild, but they have to be anchored to elements. So now obviously John gets to allocate his dice as he likes. So he's going for Firestorm.
Boom.
But if you do that, you can't use those two Z's.
Well,
you could put one of the Z's instead of one of those
Z's
and then combo something else.
So for example, you could take out that and that and replace them with the Z's.
Well, I never.
Or the two fires and then put the two fires in your shields.
Really? You can absolutely use a Z for any element.
Yeah, so you can go like, for example, like that with the two mountains.
Well, yeah, that will do that. And have then some shield. Yeah. Shutting! Okay, done. I'm gonna choose who's got dice.
So read what it says.
So this is a firestorm attack, obviously with the Zeds replacing the fire. Target loses two dice.
Right, so the difference between lose and strike. Strikes obviously strike against the shields, but lose is just straight from their pool. So Michael hasn't lost any dice yet.
Wait,
like thinking of Michael.
This is true, yeah. We've only got that, haven't we?
And he's got the special
on,
ability of taking them back. So
there we go.
That means he loses two dice, he's two down, and that ends your turn. So combos get removed unless they have a diamond next to them. Then you can use them last turn. The shields stay there, and then it goes to Molo.
Yay!
Okay.
So you remove everything.
Yep.
Have a roll. Molo's air, so he's looking all for airs. If he gets all airs, he gets to return a die.
Not the best of rolls for Molo.
No, quite
loads
a mixed bag.
Mountains.
I will keep that one. That one.
The last roll.
Cool. And I'll use my special extra reroll to...
That means you can do one die.
One die. Gotta be this one, I guess.
See, okay, that's not bad.
Yeah, that'll do.
Right, okay, so we'll start here. We will lightning strike Tony to target loses two dice.
Allocate all your dice
Tony.
First.
No, okay, he doesn't.
No.
It's sensible, you're the guy after me. There we go.
But keep in mind, Tony's got no shields. So if you lightning strike, he's a lose. So target someone who has shields with that rather, and use something that strikes against Tony.
Tony, I think, currently has the most dice at the moment.
and is going straight after me.
Okay.
Yeah. He still wants to hit me.
Yeah, he's still.
Persuade him,
by the way. Yeah. Sank about his face. Yeah.
Well, Tony, he's full of beans at the moment because he just smashed the sword in 40k.
Oh, yeah. All right, and I then put Deep Fog on.
Oh, the reroll.
Yeah.
All right, so Tony lost two dice. Obviously, this means now Tony's got only got four dice left, but if he rolls all mountains, he can get one of his dice back, which is, I suppose, in theory, easier.
Easier, yeah, yeah. I suppose.
Don't forget, Tony, you could have spent two of your...
Oh, I could have done. Yeah, got that.
Oh, three mountains.
Last reroll.
Is it a mountain?
It is.
Now, unfortunately, Z's, even though they are wild, for this purpose of getting your dice back, or for when losing all your dice, if you roll the opposite symbol, it has to be the actual symbol as opposed to a wild. But that's still pretty good for you.
Not bad.
Milo's got no shields.
Yeah. Shut up.
And I'm pretty sure he just attacked
you. Strike.
I'll reroll one of those mountains first.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so you spin that. Water.
So I can reallocate all
of them.
The sea can't stay there, by the way.
No, that's true. So I want to go for...
The way the strike works is you could put one dice in to do a one strike against someone, but then you can pump it up by adding more. That's what the plus means, extra. So you can do a maximum of a three strike. And don't forget, you can also put dice here to gain these tokens.
Yeah, yeah. Mind you, I don't need a card here.
You could take your shield out.
Yeah, risky.
He's got one for one shield. That's a special power.
Yeah, I know. It seems not worth not using it.
Yeah. Especially as I'm down to many dice as well. There ain't much I can do there, really.
Come on, Tony. I'm running out of battery.
Yeah. Oh, I'll remove one. Well, I won't do it now because it's one I can keep dice on there.
Okay, so over to me. Got five dice left here. Oh, lots of air. I'm going to keep just the one water.
Air is bad for you.
Yeah, I'm aiming just to get some dice back here. So we'll keep those, and then last reroll, I want both of these to be water, ideally.
Oh, so close.
So close. So air, I have sea fog, which seems a useful thing to do while I've got the dice to do it. I'm going to whack a couple of those in there, and Molo is shieldless, so I'm just going to smack him for one there.
Right, so it's a strike, which would go against your shields. You don't have any. Yep, you can spend those two tokens. Okay. Right, because you've got no tokens on your totem, this dissipates, and you lose control of your totem.
Oh, no. What does that mean?
Nothing. Okay. It just means he doesn't get the totem abilities anymore.
He can't get it back. No. Oh.
And is that it for your turn?
That is me done.
So now it goes to John. So...
Just scoop him.
That is a full round, by the way.
Roll him.
Let's see what...
Whoa! All the fire, all the flame. I'm going to keep those. And I'll keep him.
You don't have to allocate them now, but obviously...
No, I'm just thinking about what I'm
trying to do. It helps, yeah.
I'll just reroll that one.
How many dice you got, Milo? Only five?
None.
Didn't you just lose one?
Six dice.
Oh, Avasa. That's not the best. Strike all targets with two dice. Everyone's got shields up.
Milo doesn't have any.
Molo.
I have no shield.
But then you could just hit him with the base fire strike ability instead.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But I'm striking all shamans with one dice. Strike all targets with two dice. Yeah, no point at all. Target loses two dice. I would have liked to have done that, but no. So they're going to go into shield. I can do one, and I'll hit Milo with a two dice.
Blah.
Two goes into it.
Doodad. And I think that's all we've got.
Okay. Milo.
Right. Revenge. Probably. I don't know. Maybe not. Okay. So we got some wind and some fire and some Z's. I will reroll these two.
Ooh, one roll left, and you got
one and a half roll. No, I don't need it.
So okay, you get one of those back, and you can use your free reroll.
Bonus reroll.
That's worked for you quite well.
Okay, so now he'll be sorry. Okay, so we will scorch somebody.
I'm going to you re-roll one of your airs, I think.
I can't believe you didn't do it before you got...
I should have done, I didn't think at the time. Air.
Oh, you're
gonna... Useless.
Okay, so, scorch. Strike all shamans with two dice, which...
Does nothing.
Oh, okay. let me go back through that. Okay, remove one dice from target shield. That doesn't help me much.
But it will make, if you do it, say, from Mike, then it makes Tony hit him.
No, Tony's away.
Yeah.
He had no shield.
Yeah, it would,
that's
yeah.
That's a possibility.
And he doesn't like Tony anyway.
Tony's now just kind of weak. I can't need to damage other people. I've done everything I can to Tony.
The puppy while it's down.
Yeah.
Well, if you put it like that.
And look at the puppy's face.
Oh. What do I do?
You can do this, Mona. I have faith in you.
It's too difficult.
I mean, there's five choices. Roll a dice and see which one you're going to choose.
Not making it any easier. I'll put my shield back on. We will... So, is there any point in removing that? Because it will be Tony's roll next as
if
well.
If you remove that, you could then put all your air into that and hit him for free.
Well, no.
That's a possibility.
It's no point. If you're going to do Tony, there's no point because he's going next and he's going to scoop it up anyway.
So you want to do John or I. Yeah. John has the most effect, but Tony might want to attack me.
I can't. I don't have enough damage to do anything.
Make it enticing for someone else to hurt them.
Yeah.
I guess, yes, I can knock everybody's shields off.
But everybody?
Yeah, if I do that, I do two dice, which will knock everybody's shields.
No, shields don't get lost when you do damage. Oh. They're like a permanent minus to the damage you take.
Yeah, this ain't great. Stupid game.
And a two-dice strike will do nothing.
Yeah. Okay, I will remove Tony's dice, because, you know, fuck Tony. And, and give him a quick stab in the face as well.
So just remove that one.
Shield, but also remove one of your shields.
Oh, man, you suck.
So you lose one dice.
Stuff like that to you.
You lose one dice as well, Tony.
Tony only has three dice, but it gives him a large chance of getting it back. Well, I say large.
But you could have spent your thing.
Yes!
She's up again.
Tony does.
I'm down to throw a good chance of getting it back.
Yeah. Or not.
Or not being the case. Actually, what I will do. I think of assigning that one there.
All mountains.
There you go. One dice back.
So you get
and one
that one,
re-roll.
And you can re-roll that one as well now because you got one roll left.
There's your wind, and I'm sitting next to him.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's do this.
You can obviously use this token now.
Yeah, am I gonna?
What is this token saying?
That token is being used, and it's giving me a dice back.
Wow! Look at that. You could obviously, if you did that, only you couldn't get like it. Yeah, that just goes one side.
Just goes to one side.
Yeah, with the other one.
Used, and then I will shard burst. Adjacent shaman lose one dice each.
Right, so you and Mike.
I shall lose that and that.
So he's spending two of his tokens. Milo doesn't have a totem anymore.
Totem down. And okay, over to me. So scoop up. Five dice.
Looking for
what
waters.
Have we got? I've got wind, only the one water.
If
one wind is useful, one fire is useful, but.
I think you should go for all wind.
I would like all wind as well.
Yeah.
I will stick with the all water plan, which is not working very well here. Got two water. Yeah.
Last roll.
Ooh, that's not a good roll,
mixed
really.
Mixed bag.
A very mixed bag. What are we going to have here? So mountain, I can make target lose two dice. I think I'm going to have at least one shield.
Do you not have to put both on?
No, only because Tony has one coloured in already.
My mountain, I could do a mountain and a water for that. Yeah, it's not. Look, I can't use much of my stuff here, unfortunately. Yeah, the fire and the mountain are looking pretty useless.
This is why I reckon these should have been wild symbols, so you could just put anything down you want there.
I'm six dice, two shields up.
I'm going to go two shield up, and then I'm going to put That on there with the mountain to remove one dice from target person's shield. Molo.
Nice.
Over to you, John.
All right, so there's two full rotations. Then we're going to let these guys finish off this game, and then we'll come back and tell you where you can go see this Kickstarter, put some links behind, and tell you who won. All right, so the game has ended, and we have a new Master Shaman who will be in charge of Planet Z for the next 7 years, and that is Rokhzin from the Fire Plains.
All I can say is the lands are in trouble.
Burn it all to the ground.
I don't even know what I'm doing.
All right, so John obviously won. He killed both Mike and Tony on his last roll.
Oosh.
Molo was the first one to die.
Oosh, which I right, also killed.
Yeah, you also killed him. No, okay. Didn't you kill him?
No.
So fire killed everyone.
Yay.
As it should.
As it does.
Yeah, his character just seemed a lot more attacky than ours.
Yeah.
Neither of you guys went anywhere near him. Admittedly, I didn't either, but that was because I was killing you guys. Yeah.
Well, you could pick it on Tony.
I didn't have to reach as far.
All right, so just to mention as well, this game is obviously, we've just played the 4-player version, and you can play this as 3-player version. On the other side of the board, so I've got the fire board here, and I think the water one is the other option. This forms up to form a second type of game. This is the 2-player version, as indicated by the little 2-player section. You can do either air versus earth, or you can do water versus fire. And this is called the monolith. This is the 2-player version. What you do here is basically you're trying to empower your side of the monolith before the other person does it, the other shaman does it. And you have your own little section here. So for example, this guy can unlock dice from the monolith, either his or his other person. You can reroll any unused dice. And you can take one dice from the pool or drain one dice into the pool that's taken from your opponents. And if you roll mountains here, you can get extra, 2 mountains can get you a mountain back. Well, I'm explaining this really badly, but on your beginning of your turn, let's say, who's this fire and water? This goes into the pool in the middle, yeah? Then each person gets 3 dice of both.
Is it fire and water?
Is it fire and water?
It's earth and
fire. Well, either way, yeah, you get the opposite element. You get 3 dice of each, and that's what you begin with. The other person does the same, and then you take turns alternating rolling the dice. If you roll Z's in this one, Z's are not wild. They are, if you roll Z's, they get locked.
Blank, can't they?
Yeah, they get locked into Danny, and you don't get to use them until your next round. And dice you use to put into the combos are removed from your pool. So if you go, for example, like this first one down at the bottom here, you roll 2 mountains, a fire and a water, and you lock that in. Next turn, you'll only have 2 dice to roll. But if you roll both, in this case, mountains, you get an extra dice from the pool, which is a mountain die. So I'm going to ignore the mountain, let's say it's a water, and then you get to roll, and same again. So that's the 2-player version. This is actually really quite interesting, this one. It's kind of a race to get to the top of the monolith. Yeah. It's really interesting in that you're not really attacking each other. So like you saw this one that we just played, yeah.
You've got ways of interacting with your opponent, though, and foiling their plans, it seems. You can take dice
slowing them down, yeah.
Yeah.
So this one's quite interesting, and it's completely different to the one you played, which is a completely take that sort of King of Tokyo style game, where instead of trying to control an area, you're just beating the crap out of each other. Whereas this one, it's a lot more, not docile, but you're just slowing the other person down to do your job.
Yeah, it's interesting that you have to take dice out of your pool and leave them locked in on your monolith. So you're making yourself have less options by going towards victory. So I imagine there's lots of different paths you can take to go there. Kind of like locking loads of dice early to get a big difficult one out of the way. Or you kind of like build up all your dice pool before then trying to lock in the dice by buying extra dice and things. So it seems lots of different ways to play that version.
This one seems like the obvious thing to do is to go the smaller ones first. But I find that a less optimum way to go. Because once you lock in these early ones, you're struggling to get those 2 dice extra, where going for a big one first and then going to the smaller ones works better. But that's just my opinion. Right, so you get that game as well. So you get this game, you get the flip side, which is the 4-player, which we just played here. And obviously you get all these cool dice.
You get your totems and things.
Yeah, you get your Kickstarter exclusive totems if you back this game, which comes February the 16th, 2017. I'll put a link below in the show notes to the Kickstarter. And you can go check that out if you're interested. Or a brief synopsis, what did you guys think?
I enjoyed it.
You won.
Yeah, I won. So any game that I win, I really, really enjoy. So
nice little quick, breezy dice game.
Yeah, I'm not... Do you know what? I'm not much of a board gamer, so...
No.
It's really difficult for me to judge on this. I enjoyed it. It was fun. It was fun to play with. These guys worked as a four player. Be interesting to see that thing.
The monolith.
The monolith.
Well, next time
we round, but yeah,
next time we round, I'll say yeah. Player.
So yeah, not a lot. I can say.
Well, yeah, it seems like a nice, quick enough game. In fact, even while we were playing kind of cagey this time round, it still was fairly rapid game and wrapped up nicely. Yeah, fun enough. Yep.
Tony.
Nice, quick, nice game of a type, really. Nice filler game.
Mike?
I really actually quite like the player. This is only the Kickstarter preview
prototype,
kit that you've got here, the prototype stuff. I really like the dice. Dice are really good. Nice, solid dice. I mean, all the art's actually really good as well. I don't know if it comes from a particular kind of property that he's got the dice from or the art from, or whether he's invested and got all the art made himself. But yeah, really nicely presented.
You can obviously go to their Facebook page or their website and go check it out. Why won't this zoom in? Come on. Go on. You can do this. There we go. There you go. Information. Take it. Right, yeah. So, I think so as well. I like the Monolith game better than the other one. But they're both pretty good. Both pretty quick. I don't know how much this is going to cost, but obviously go check out the Kickstarter and see what other stuff it unlocks. I know they're talking about unlocking... like, this is the dice, and as Mike said,
they're
quality dice, but
I mean, these are perfectly good.
They're okay, not bad quality dice. But
they're upgrading it if you reach a certain goal. So, and I think obviously this is all prototype stuff, but there will be better components and stuff, which is pretty good. Anyway, so this is Elemen'z from Bad Cat Games. If you're interested, go check it out. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, mate.
Cool.